Welcome all. So today we are going to discuss here experiment number 10. Write a Java program using OOP features to implement the following scheduling algorithms. So first we are going to discuss is FCFS, first come first serve algorithm. So here in this case we are going to accept some processes from the user, and according to that we are going to accept some burst time for each and every process. So for that particular purpose, here we are using scanner class to accept some data from user. So let us start with the first one. So first of all, class FCFS. So this is our main function. So declare some variables. So here to accept or to store some data, we are using different arrays. So first array is for burst time, second one is for process, number of processes, third one is for waiting time, and fourth one is for turnaround time. And these are the temporary variables, I, J, N, total, position, and temporary. And these are the two different float variables which are required for calculation purpose, to calculate average. First of all, average waiting time, and second is average turnaround time. So use the scanner class and create its object. Then from user, just accept number of processes you want for this particular algorithm. So here user going to enter his number of processes, 5, 4, 3, as per his choice. So first of all, initialize all these arrays. First one is the process, second burst time, third one is the waiting time, and fourth one is the turnaround time. So as per the user requirement, user is going to enter number of processes is the 4. So for that particular purpose, from user you want to receive some data is in the form of burst time. So for that particular purpose, we are going to iterate this particular for loop for 4 times. So first of all, process is 1 and his burst time. Accept that burst time from user. So increment the process by 1 for second process, and so on. So here in this case, or here in this for loop, you are going to accept some data from user. So after that, in case of FCFS, assume that all the processes arrived at time 0. So for that particular purpose, inside the waiting time array, initialize first process to 0, means this particular process arrive at 0. So after that, we are going to calculate the waiting time for each and every process. So for that particular purpose, we have considered here is that waiting time of first process is 0. After that, we are going to start the second calculation from first position. So waiting time of i means the value of i is 1, is again 0. So for j is equal to 0, j less than i, j plus plus. So calculate the waiting time. Waiting time plus is equal to burst time. So whatever be the burst time entered by user is added with first waiting time of that process. Assume that first waiting time is 0 and the second burst time first burst time for that particular process is 10. So 0 plus 10 is the 10. So the waiting time for first process, first one is the 0th process, second one is this one is the first process, is 10. So again, calculate or store that total inside this total variable. So likewise, update this or iterate this particular for loop to calculate the waiting time for each and every process. So after that, once you have done with all these processes, calculate the average waiting time of all these processes, total divided by n. So n is nothing but number of processes. So after that, you have to calculate the average turnaround time. For that particular purpose, again we are using this particular for loop. At the same time, we are going to display each and every process with respect to table. So these are the contents which we are going to display at user end: process, burst time, waiting time, and turnaround time. So we are going to iterate this particular for loop for 4 times. So first one, calculate the turnaround time. So turnaround time is nothing but the waiting time and the burst time required to complete that particular process is nothing but turnaround time. So burst time of first process plus waiting time of first process is nothing but turnaround time of that first process. So here in this case, burst time of 0th process is 0 plus waiting time of 0th process, sorry, burst time of 0th process is 10 plus waiting time of 0th process is 0. So 10 plus 0 is 10. So similarly, increment the turnaround time by 1 and store inside this total. So finally, display that turnaround time here. Store this turnaround time, and finally we are going to calculate the turnaround time here in this case, average turnaround time. So display the content, process of I, burst time of I, waiting time of I and turnaround time of I. And finally, we are going to display the average waiting time and average turnaround time here. So let us execute this particular example. So first of all, javac fcfs dot java. First of all, compile that program. fcfs, compile that program. After that, run that file. So he is going to first of all ask you that enter the number of processes. So here suppose we are going to enter 4. So then this particular for loop is going to iterate for 4 times. So first of all, enter the first process burst time is assume that 10, second one is 4, third one is 5 and fourth one is 3. And once you are going to enter here, you will get all the data after calculating the average turnaround time and average waiting time. So this is the first 10 is the first burst time for first process, second is the 4, 5, 3. So waiting time, is calculated with the help of formula, just like initially for first process we have initialized that waiting time of first process is 0. So by default this is 0, and we have calculated the waiting time for second process is in the form like waiting time of first process plus the burst time of first process is 0 plus 10 is the 10. For second, third process, 10 plus 4 is the 14, and for last process, 14 plus 5 is the 19. And similarly for turnaround time, so the total time required to complete this process means burst time plus waiting time. So 10 plus 0 is the 10, 4 plus 10 is the 14, 5 plus 14 is the 19, 3 plus 19 is the 22. And here is the average waiting time for that particular task, and this is the turnaround time for that particular process. Thank you.